tells me, I'm not good enough for this. I don't know if I can face tomorrow. I don't know if I can go to school because you don't know what I'm like. You don't know what I'm struggling with. You don't know my real story. You don't even know me. That's what we think. And we push people away with our defensive walls. And we don't let anybody in. And we come to school with a facade that we don't want anyone to know what we're actually struggling with. Because if people know, sometimes we don't know what to do with people's pain. Pain scares us. Pain makes us think, no, like, let's just make it better. Let's fix it. And that's why we have anxiety, because we're trying to fix people's problems, telling them what they should or should not do. But I'll tell you something, there's a lot of power in bringing people closer. There's a lot of power in letting your wall down and allowing yourself to be seen, but to also know how to hold space for people when they decide to become that courageous. Because it's not easy. It's not easy to come to school and say, hey, I might look really good on the outside, but on the inside, I'm suffering right now. It would be hard to do that. It takes a lot of courage. And we all know the answers. We all know that, oh, you don't know the battle of the person next to you. We all heard that. We click like on all those Instagram posts that say, yeah, you don't know the battles that people are facing. But it's one thing to click like, and it's another thing to actually know how to live that out. But here's what I know, is that we all are completely capable of holding space for people who are in deep pain. Guys, we don't have to put up with mental health issues. We don't have to have a world where people are constantly living in pain. We don't have to have a world where 8-year-olds are struggling with suicide. You know, we have the power to write one another's stories. We're always told that we write our own story, and there's truth to that, but there's a lot more truth in the fact that you write the story of the person next to you by the words you say and by the space you hold for them. If you're constantly calling someone stupid, or if you're constantly like putting someone down or judging them for their race or color or their background or their gender identity, if you're constantly placing a bar over them that's super low, you slut, you're stupid, you just got nothing going for you, if you constantly are putting that bar up for them, that's the level they'll live to. We need to learn what it's like to see people, to really, really see people, and to call them up, to write a new story for them, because sometimes people have no strength to write their own story. They got nothing left, but you could write a new story for them. You could see something different. Let me tell you, when my son was in the depths of some of his crisis, I would drink myself to sleep every night. Not because I woke up one day thinking, man, I just want to be an alcoholic. Because I was in deep pain. And I had some well-intended friends at that time saying, Connie, I think we should talk about your drinking problem. And I'm like, no, my drinking problem is the last thing you should be worried about. Ask me why I'm drinking. If you're at a time in your life where you're facing like some decisions, some actions, some behaviors that are concerning people, I can guarantee you there's a lot underneath it. Your drug addiction, your struggle with alcohol, your struggle with giving yourself to any guy or any girl that comes past you, I can guarantee you there's a lot underneath that. I can guarantee you that underneath it, it's a lot of pain, and we like to medicate it. But if we wrote one another's stories really well, you know, there wouldn't be half as many alcoholics, there wouldn't be did you know that our mental health system, that the hospitals have no room for the need of people needing to come and be taken care of? And these are extreme cases. But our hospitals don't need to be filled, guys. We could be the answer to the person next to us. We could be the one who makes a difference. And what it means is just putting down our guard and saying, hey, I don't understand everything, but I'm gonna be there. Nothing will break my connection. I'm gonna see my enemy differently. I'm not gonna look at him like he's trying to wreck my life. I'm gonna lay down myself for my brother, my sister. And it's not just Hallmark that says that. That's stuff that changes the world. So instead of me talking about it, I'd like for you to experience it. And what I would like is for you, young man, could you come here? Yes, come. What's your name?
Artyom.